Well, many of us are familiar with zombies, but one local researcher is hunting for zombie crabs.
First Alert meteorologist Pierce Legion has more on a different kind of walker.
It sounds like something straight out of a horror movie. Zombie crabs roaming aimlessly along the shore. For mud crabs up and down the East Coast, it's a scenario that's all too real. East Carolina University researcher April Blakesley is studying these so-called zombie crabs.
There's a parasite that actually has come over from the Gulf of Mexico, probably transported with oysters when oysters were moved around a lot.
This parasite starts out looking like an ordinary barnacle, but once it attaches to a crab's abdomen,
it kind of takes over the inside of the crab. It actually produces almost like these little tendrils all throughout the crab.
These tendrils extend all the way to the crab's central nervous system, and even worse,
it actually feminizes males. So this is what they call it. So the males actually think that they're carrying eggs, and in fact, it's actually the reproductive sort of sac of the parasite itself.
The crabs basically become stumbling, lethargic parasite baby makers and lose their ability to reproduce themselves. Blakesley hopes to learn how the mud crab population is affected by this invasive parasite. The good news, it's no threat to edible species like blue crab and is no threat to humans. Your next trip to the coast may be a little more apocalyptic if you run across a batch of these crabs. In Greenville, meteorologist Pierce Legion, not on your side.
All right, Blakesley plans to study mud crab populations over the next year in the Pamlico and Neuse Rivers.
Yeah, she says the crabs will likely develop some natural defense over that parasite over time.